الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد، يا علي يا عظيم يا غفور يا رحيم. أنت الرب العظيم الذي ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. وهذا شهر عظمته وكرمته وشرفته وفضلته على الشهور، وهو شهر الذي فرشت صيامه عليه، وهو شهر رمضان الذي أنزلت فيه القرآن، هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، وجعلت فيه ليلة القدر وجعلتها خيرا من ألف شهر. فيا ذا المن ولا يمن عليك من علي بفقاك ركبتي من النار في من تمن عليه، وادخلني الجنة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم أدخل على أهل القبور الشرور. اللهم أغن كل فقير. اللهم أشفي كل جائع. اللهم اكس كل أريان. اللهم اقض دين كل مدين. اللهم فرج عن كل مكروب. اللهم رد كل غريب. اللهم فك كل عسير. اللهم أصلح كل فاسد من أمور المسلمين. اللهم اشف كل مريض. اللهم سد فقرنا بغناك. اللهم غير سوء أهالنا بحسن حالك. اللهم اقض عنا الدين واقنا من الفقر، إنك على كل شيء قدير. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم رب شهر رمضان الذي أنزلت فيه القرآن وافترضت على عبادك فيه الصيام، صل على محمد وآل محمد، وارزقني هج بيتك الحرام في عامي هذا وفي كل عام، واغفر لي تلك الذنوب الإثام فإنه لا يغفرها غيرك يا رحمن يا علام.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم إني أفتقر الثناء بحمدك، وأنت مسدد للصواب بمنك، وأيقنت أنك أنت أرحم الراحمين في موضع العفو والرحمة، وأشد المعاقبين في موضع النكال والنقمة، وعظم المتجبرين في موضع الكبرياء والعظمة. اللهم أذنت لي في دعائك ومسألتك، فاسمع يا سميع مدحتي، وأجب يا رحيم دعوتي، وأقل يا غفور عثرتي. فكم يا إلهي من قربة قد فرجتها، وهموم قد كشفتها، وعثرة قد أقلتها، ورحمة قد نشرتها، وحلقة بلاء قد فككتها. الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ صاحبة ولا ولدا، ولم يكن له شريك في الملك، ولم يكن له ولي من الذل، وكبره تكبيرا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله بجميع محامده كلها، على جميع نعمه كلها. الحمد لله لا مضاد له في ملكه، ولا منازع له في أمره. الحمد لله الذي لا شريك له في خلقه، ولا شبيه له في عظمته. الحمد لله الفاشي في الخلق أمره، وحمده الظاهر بالكرب مجده. الباسط بالجود يداه، الذي لا تنقص خزائنه ولا تزيده كثرة العطاء إلا جودا وكرما، إنه هو العزيز الوهاب. اللهم إني أسألك قليلا من كثير، مع حاجة به إليه عظيمة، وغناك عنه قديم، وهو عندي كثير، وهو عليك سهل يسير. اللهم إن عفوك عن ذنبي، وتجاوزك عن خطيئتي، وصفحك عن ظلمي، وسترك على قبيح عملي، وحلمك عن كثير جرمي عندما كان من خطئي وعمدي. أطمعني في أن أسألك ما لا أستوجبه منك، الذي رزقتني من رحمتك، وأريتني من قدرتك، وعرفتني من إجابتك، فصرت أدعوك آمنا وأسألك مستعنسا، لا خائفا ولا وجلا، مدلا عليك فيما قصدت فيه إليك. فإن أبطع عني أتبت بجهلي عليك، ولعل الذي أبطع عني هو خير لي لعلمك بآقبة الأمور. فلم أر مولا كريما أصبر على عبد لئيم منك علي. يا رب إنك تدعوني فولي عنك، وتتحبب إليك وتبغض إليك، وتتودد إلي فلا أقبل منك، كأن لي التطول عليك، فلم يمنع كذلك من الرحمة لي والإحسان إلي والتفضل علي بجودك وكرمك. فارحم عبدك الجاهل، وجد عليه بفضل إحسانك، إنك جواد كريم. الحمد لله مالك الملك، مجري الفلك، مسخر الرياح، فالق الإصباح، ديان الدين، رب العالمين. الحمد لله على حلمه بعد علمه، والحمد لله على عفوه بعد قدرته، والحمد لله على طول أناته في غضبه، وهو قادر على ما يريد. الحمد لله خالق الخلق، باسط الرزق، فالق الإصباح، ذي الجلال والإكرام، والفضل والإنعام، الذي بعد فلا يراه، وقرب فشهد النجوى، تبارك وتعالى. الحمد لله الذي ليس له منازع يعادله، ولا شبيه يشاكله، ولا ظهير يعاضده، قهر بعزته العزى، وتواضع لعظمته العظمى، فبلغ بقدرته ما يشاء. الحمد لله الذي يجيبني حين أنادي، ويستر علي كل عورة وعنى عصي، ويعذب النعمة علي فلا أجازي، فكم من موهبة هنيئة قد أعطاني، وعظيمة مخوفة قد كفاني، وبهجة مونقة قد أراني، فأثني عليه حامدا وأذكره مسبحا. الحمد لله الذي لا يهتك حجابه، ولا يغلق بابه، ولا يرد سائله، ولا يخيب آمله. الحمد لله الذي يؤمن الخائفين، وينجي الصالحين، ويرفع المستضعفين، ويضع المستكبرين، ويهلك ملوكا ويستخلف آخرين. والحمد لله قاسم الجبارين، مبير الظالمين مدرك الهاربين نكال الظالمين صريخ المستصرخين موضي حاجات الظالمين معتمد المؤمنين. الحمد لله الذي من خشيته ترعد السماء وسكانها وترجف الأرض وأمارها وتموج البحار ومن يسبح في غمراتها. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله الذي يخلق ولم يخلق ويرزق ولا يرزق ويطعم ولا يطعم ويميت الأحياء ويحيي الموتى وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير. اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وأمينك وصفيك وحبيبك وخيرتك من خلقك وحافظ سرك ومبلغ رسالاتك أفضل وأحسن وأجمل وأكمل وأزكى وأنمى وأطيب وأطهر وأسنى وأكثر ما صليت وباركت وترحمت وتحننت وسلمت على أحد من عبادك وأنبيائك ورسلك وصفوتك وأهل الكرامة عليك من خلقك. اللهم صل على علي أمير المؤمنين ووصي رسول رب العالمين عبدك ووليك وأخي رسولك وحجتك على خلقك وآيتك الكبرى والنبأ العظيم. وصل على الصديقة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة النساء العالمين. وصل على صفي الرحمة وإمام الهدى الحسن والحسين سيدي شباب أهل الجنة. وصل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي. والخلف الهادي المهدي حجتك على عبادك وأمنائك في بلادك صلاة كثيرة دائما. اللهم صل على ولي أمرك القائم المعمل والعدن المنتظر وحفه بملائكتك المقربين وأيده بروح القدس يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعله الداعي إلى كتابك والقائم بدينك استخلفه في الأرض كما استخلفت الذين من قبله. مكن له دينه الذي ارتضيته له أبدله من بعده خوفه أمنا يعبدك لا يشرك بك شيئا. اللهم عزه وعزز به وانصره وانتصر به وانصره نصرا عزيزا وافتح له فتحا يسيرا واجعل له من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا. اللهم أذهر به دينك وسنة نبيك حتى لا يستخفي بشيء من الحق مخافة أحد من الخلق. اللهم إنا نرغب إليك في دولة كريمة تعز بها الإسلام وأهله وتذل بها النفاق وأهله وتجعلنا فيها من الدعاة إلى طاعتك والقادة إلى سبيلك وترزقنا بها كرامة الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم ما عرفتنا من الحق فحملنا، وما قصرنا عنه فبلغنا. اللهم المن به شعثنا، واشعب به صدعنا، وارتق به فتقنا، وكثر به قلتنا، وعزز به ذلتنا، واغن به عائلنا، واغذ به أم مغرمنا، واجبر به فقرنا، وسد به خلتنا، ويسر به عسرنا، وبيض به وجوهنا، وفك به أسرنا، وأنجح به طلبتنا، وأنجز به مواعيدنا، واستجب به دعوتنا، وأعطنا به سولنا، وبلغنا به من الدنيا والآخرة آمالنا، وعطنا به فوق رغبتنا يا خير المسؤولين وأوسع المعطين. اشف به صدورنا، وأذهب به غيظ قلوبنا، واهدنا به لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك، إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. وانصرنا به على عدوك وعدونا، إله الحق، آمين. اللهم إنا نشكو إليك فقد نبينا صلواتك عليه وآله، وخيبة ولينا، وكثرة عدونا، وقلة عددنا، وشدة الفتن بنا، وتظاهر الزمان علينا. فصل على محمد وآله، وأعنا على ذلك بفتح منك تعجله، وبضر تكشفه، ونصر تعزه، وسلطان حق تظهره، ورحمة منك تجللناها، وعافية منك تلبسناها، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم برحمتك في الصالحين فأدخلنا، وفي عليين فارفعنا، وبكأس من معين من عين سلسبيل فاسقنا، ومن الحور العين برحمتك فزوجنا، ومن البلدان المخلدين كأنهم لؤلؤ مكنون فاخدمنا، ومن ثمار الجنة ولحوم الطير فأطعمنا، ومن ثياب السندس والحرير والاستبرق فالبسنا، وليلة القدر وحج بيتك الحرام، وقتلا في سبيلك فوفق لنا، وصالح الدعاء والمسألة فاستجب لنا. وإذا جمعت الأولين والآخرين يوم القيامة فارحمنا، وبراءة من النار فاكتب لنا، وفي جهنم فلا تهن لنا، وفي عذابك وهوانك فلا تبتلنا، ومن الزقوم والضريع فلا تطعمنا، ومع الشياطين فلا تجعلنا، وفي النار على وجوهنا فلا تكببنا، ومن ثياب النار وسرابيل القطران فلا تلبسنا، ومن كل سوء يا لا إله إلا أنت، بحق لا إله إلا أنت فنجنا. صل على بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم إني أسألك أن تجعل فيما تقضي وتقدر من الأمر المحتوم في الأمر الحكيم، من القضاء الذي لا يرد ولا يبدل، أن تكتبني من حجاج بيتك الحرام المبرور حجهم، المشكور سعيهم، المغفور ذنوبهم، المكفر عن سيئاتهم، وأن تجعل فيما تقضي وتقدر أن تطيل عمري في خير وعافية، وتوسع في رزقي، وتجعلني ممن تنتصر به لدينك ولا تستبدل بي غيري. أعوذ بجلال وجهك الكريم أن ينقضي عني شهر رمضان أو يطلع الفجر من ليلتي هذه، ولك قبلي تبعة أو ذنب تعذبني عليه. اللهم صل على محمد وآل. سورة مباركة الفاتحة.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين، فذلك الذي يدؤ اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين. فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون، الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماءون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. صلوات.
سورة المباركة الفاتحة فأولى ومرحومين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. صلى الله عليك يا رسول الله، صلى الله عليك وعلى أهل بيتك المظلومين، صلى الله عليك يا أبا عبد الله، صلى الله عليك يا ابن رسول الله، يا رحمة الله الواسعة، ويا باب نجاة الأمة، ما خاب من تمسك بكم وأمن من لجأ إليكم. يا ليتنا يا ليتنا كنا معكم سادتي فنفوز فوزا عظيما. قال الله تعالى في كتابه المجيد: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. آمنا بالله، صدق الله العلي العظيم. اللهم صل على محمد. Respected brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In the process of making ourselves better people, in the topic of personal development, which is connected with akhlaq, there is no room for us not to depend on dua. We may discuss whatever we discuss, however, dua is a cornerstone of personal development. Dua is everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ayah number 186 of Surah Al-Baqarah, series of the verses which talk about Shahr Ramadan, fasting, Suyam, from 183, 184, 185, Allah gives us the rules, the laws of fasting. And in ayah number 187, it brings the issue of dua. So the ayah clearly says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ, the kaf here, سَأَلَكَ, ka refers to Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ, and if they ask you, Rasulullah, عَنِّي, about me, Allah, فَإِنِّي قَرِيب, I'm so near to them, I'm so closer to them. Ujibu da'wata da'i, I answer the supplicate of the suppliant when he supplicates for me. Ujibu da'wata da'i idha da'a. Here there are three things together. One is the supplicant, you and me when we do dua. Two is supplication, which is dua. And then there is one whom we are supplicating to, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the triangle which we see any time when we do dua, there are three things there. There is you, there is Allah, there is dua. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي. دَعْوَة, dua. الدَّاعِي, the person who supplicates to Allah. الدُّعَى, أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِي. أَنِّي هِيَ مِنْ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. But like any other dua or like any ibadah, there are conditions. With dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says clearly, فَلْ يَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِي. These two conditions, we need them in dua. Number one, we need to make sure we respond whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي. When we do dua, we supplicate to Allah, we need to know that it is Allah we are doing dua to. It's the one we are asking Him. So وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي, iman is very important. Sometimes really we find ourselves even, when our iman is so strong, you can see the way we behave in front of dua. Sometimes our hands are not raised, maybe we are not in a state of wudu, maybe we are not facing Qibla, and maybe our awareness, that wudu qalb, the heart is not there. So sometimes we happen in us until the matter is so huge, so big, that we try to bring all these muqaddimat of dua, prerequisites of dua before we do dua. Allah says iman is very important. If you can do all, remember to have iman. Remember the one whom you are asking is the one who is capable of giving you in the time where you have lost hope. No one is there to help you, he will be there for you. When all the doctors have said, you and your wife, you are not going to have children, Allah will give you. When you say that this disease is the one which is going to take me away from this world, he will cure you. وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينِ. Doctors, the medicine, the facilities are all there to help us, but الشافي هو الله سبحانه وتعالى. So when we have that iman, وَلْيُؤْمِنُ بِهِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ, then they will be able to be guided, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Ayah 186 of Surah Al-Baqarah. Sometimes we ask ourselves the question, what's the importance of dua? Why do I need to ask Allah really? He knows what is in my heart before me saying. Why then should I ask him? Even if I don't say anything, he knows. So why do I? Why should I sit down? Why should I face Qibla? Why should I? Should I have wudu, ablution? Why should I sometimes wear nice clothing, be presentable? Why and why and why? Allah says in Ayah 77 of Surah Al-Furqan, Surah number 25, last Ayah. In the middle of it, he says, "Qul, say, Ya Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad." Qul, ma ya'ba'u bikum rabbi lawla du'a'ukum. Very heavy statement in this ayah, last ayah of Surah Al-Furqan. For those brothers who are there for tafsir of Quran, inshallah, we'll reach them. In detail. Qul, tell them, ma ya'ba'u bikum rabbi, my Lord would never care for you, lawla du'a'ukum, if it were not for your dua. If it is not for dua, Allah wouldn't even pay attention to you. And this we see in dua comment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what do we say? Ya man ismuhu dawa, wa dhikruhu shifa, wa ta'atuhu ghina, irham man rasu mali, arrajah wa silahul buka. Ya sabiha al-ni'am, ya dafi'an al-ni'am, ya mura mustafishina fi'l-ulam, ya aliman la yu'allam, salli ala Muhammadin wa'ali. How do we continue again? Ya after then, salli ala Muhammadin wa'ali Muhammad, waghfir, wafal bima, anta ahlu. Whatever you see fit for me, do it for me. I don't have anything except dua. It is dua which I want. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever we have issues. But when it comes to our akhlaq, we want to have that personal development, dua is everything. We may talk about the exercise of the soul and whatever we have mentioned in this majalis. But dua is of the utmost importance. Why? Because we want to reach the excellence of our deeds and actions, and that's why we need dua. Alhamdulillah. Followers of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, we have a treasure of dua. We have, if you go for example to the website, duas.org, easy to access. Duas.org, all these duas we recite, they are there. Before that, we used to have a fatiha. Each house of Mu'miniyah, all of Ahlul Bayt, we have at least mafatiha jinan. So we recite this dua. But do you know the compiler of Mafatihul Jinan, Sheikh Abbas Al-Ummi? Inshallah, next time, brothers and sisters, you go for ziyara of Amir al-Mu'minin Ali bin Abi Talib alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Try to ask the people of Najaf, where is the grave of Sheikh Abbas Al-Ummi? He's buried near the Haram of Amir al-Mu'minin, inside actually, if you can say. Go, pray for him, recite Fatiha for him, thank him for the work which he did. Sheikh Abbas Al-Ummi Marhum is known as Al-Ummi because he came from Qum. And this Ummi, scholars of Qum, Najaf Najafi, is an Ummi. He left his city just to search for dua from Ma'sumin alayhi wasalam. Some of his colleagues were talking to him and were saying, Sheikh, your level is not on the level of you sitting down, writing dua, prepare dua for people. No, you need to teach fiqh and usul. You know, there is something within Hausa and scholars. In order for you to be a proper scholar, you need to teach fiqh and usul. You ask all the mullahs and the shuyukh, they will tell you. For you to do with dua is like any student can do this. This is not for you. But Sheikh Abbas Al-Ummi has reached that level of spiritualism. He said, I need to prepare something for the Ummah in order for them to have something somewhere, dua in order for them to use it to help them. He used to make sure he is in a state of wudu. He goes, he hears, for example, this Sheikh has narrated this dua, he will go. Ask him, talk to him, narrate the dua, he will write it down until he compiled the book Mafatih Al-Jinan, the keys or gateways, the keys for paradise. He reached the level of spiritualism. Those who have seen him, they say when he was in Najaf, he used to go to the cemetery, the biggest cemetery in the world according to what we believe, Wadi Salam. There are two Wadi. Wadi Salam, the valley of peace. All the Mu'mineen, when they die, wherever they are buried, their souls will be taken to Wadi Salam. Even if you are buried in Mombasa, you are buried in Dar es Salaam, in New York, in Paris, so long as you believe in the Imam of Wasiyul Awsiya, Amirul Mu'minin, Ali bin Abi Talib, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Your soul will be closer to him. And that's why there are some people. And fiqh masail is allowed. If I die, bury me where I die, but I ask you to make my body as amana, as trust. Anytime you are able to transfer my body to Wadi Salam, please do so. And there are many people who have done so. Their bodies were buried somewhere. After some time, they were taken to be buried in Wadi Salam. Why? Because we want to be closer to Amir al-Mu'minin. We can't be closer to Rasulullah in Medina because we want a situation there. But at least we can be closer to Amir al-Mu'minin. So Sheikh Abbas Al-Ummi used to go there. He sits and he recites Fatiha. He prays for the people who are buried there. Of course, when we say Mu'minin will be buried there, there is a state of purification. You may be a Shia of Amir al-Mu'minin. But sometimes we do mistakes. So there is that process of purification. According to some scholars, they call it the state of squeezing. So if there is something wrong in our body, we will be squeezed in order for it to come out. Sheikh Abbas Al-Ummi one day was sitting in Wadi Salam. He saw a body of one marhum being buried there. People came. It's a busy place for those who have been there, you know. They carried the body, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah. They reached to the grave. They prepared the grave. There are specific people who do that. So when they were there,
Sheikh Hassan means watching.
He saw them taking the body. They have already washed the body, is covered with kafan. They have prayed, they have even done the ziyarah of Amirul Mu'minin.
Now the body is being taken to be buried there. He looked at it, they buried the body, and after some time they left. Sheikh Abbas al-Kumi looked at some people who were there, the family members who are crying. They are crying because this marhum is buried there. All of a sudden he saw creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are coming down with whips. And they were whipping this mayyit, this marhum who is just freshly buried there. He could see it. The people who were there near the grave couldn't see it. They were crying as a normal. We are crying from our home. But he saw that which they couldn't see. He left. After that, he went home. He became sick. For more than a month, he couldn't come out. Why? Because he saw something which terrified him and other people couldn't see. Why? This one, we leave it for the scholars. Whenever you get time, inshallah, maraji, ask them. They will explain to you better. I don't have any answer to this particular question. But Sheikh Abbas al-Kumi, the way scholars say, he reached that level because of purity of the heart. And he paid keen interest with dua. So now coming back to our topic. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ قُلْ مَا يَأْبَأُ بِكُمْ رَبِّي لَوْلَا دُعَاؤُكُمْ قُلْ أُدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. All these verses, they talk about dua. So when we come to self-development, we need dua. Which dua can we take in order for us to make ourselves to be better? Mafatihul Jinan, if I open, there are many duas. And then you have Sahifa Sajadiyya. And then you have Misbahul Mutahajjid, Li Sheikh Al Kaf'ami. All these are the books of dua, many. However, there is one dua, and today I want to read only part of this dua in order for us, every time when we remember, what can I do in order for me to develop myself spiritually, refer to this dua. This is the dua which is known as dua makarim al-akhlaq. Makarim al-akhlaq. Makarim, these are the highest level, the pure levels of akhlaq, the highest level of akhlaq. Remember the narration from the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. The Holy Prophet says, innama bu'iftu li utammima makarim al-akhlaq. Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam has the dua which is known as makarim al-akhlaq. The Holy Prophet says, I have been sent to perfect the best morals. All the messengers of Allah, Nabiullah Adam, Nuh, Sulaiman, Isa, Idris, Yahya, all of them alayhim salam came to teach akhlaq. Rasulullah came to perfect the good morals or the best morals. Imam Zainul Abidin in dua makarim al-akhlaq, he starts by this dua, and please, I ask you sincerely, humbly, when you have time, brothers, sisters, sit down, have dua makarim al-akhlaq in front of you. If you can manage to give this as hadiyah to our Sunni brothers, give it as hadiyah. You don't have anything to do except this dua to give it as hadiyah, give it to them. You will see wonders. Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. وَبَلِّغْ بِإِيمَانِي أَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانِ. O Allah, I ask you to cause my faith to reach the most perfect faith. He doesn't say, O Allah, I ask you Iman. He says, no, I ask you Akmal al-Iman. I have Iman. My Iman is not coming. It's not complete. I ask you to make it to be coming. واجعل يقيني أفضل اليقين. Make my yaqeen to be the best of yaqeen. Yaqeen, certitude. Yaqeen is the one which will make you to continue to worship Allah day in, day out. Whether you are poor, whether you are rich, whether you are fit, whether you are sick, you will continue to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of your yaqeen. Imam Zainul Abidin says, make my yaqeen to be the excellent yaqeen, excellent certainty. وَانْتَهِ بِنِيَّتِي إِلَىٰ أَحْسَنِ النِّيَّاتِ وَبِعَمَلِي إِلَىٰ أَحْسَنِ الْأَعْمَالِ. My niyyah, intention, make it to be ahsan. Make it better niyyah. Sometimes shaitan plays with us. He makes us our niyyah. We have intention. I want to do good things. Especially when you do things for others. Shaitan is shaitan, wallah. There's nothing we can say except shaitan is shaitan al-la'im. You have intention, I want to help people, I want to make sure they become better people. All of a sudden shaitan comes and he says, well, you know what, they don't even say thank you to you. Why do you want to do favor to people who even don't say thank you? And we forget, we say, well, I'm not going to help them. So niyyah is very important. And that's why Rasulullah, when he was asked about niyyah, do I need to have niyyah for each and everything which I do? He says yes. Companions in terms of learning from the Holy Prophet, they were like you and me. Someone asked and he said, Ya Rasulullah, even eating and drinking, do I have to have intention? Rasulullah says yes. Even eating and drinking, have a niyyah that you eat and drink in order for you to have strength to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly. That intention is very important. And then my amal to be ahsan al-a'mal. I don't just want to do a'mal, but I want my a'mal to be the best of a'mal. Whatever I do should come with a good result. Then Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam says, wa waffir bi lutfika niyyati. Complete my intention through your greatness. وَصَحِّ بِمَا عِنْدَكَ يَقِينِ. Rectify my certainty through what is with you. Maybe my yaqeen sometimes go up and down because of turbulences in our lives. Make sure, Ya Allah, you rectify my yaqeen. وَاسْتَصْلِحْ بِقُدْرَتِكَ مَا فَسَدَ مِنِّي. مَا فَسَدَ مِنِّي. And set right what is corrupt in me through your power. Sometimes corruption may come, and then we need to start afresh. So Imam Zainul Abidin teaches us how to go to ask that. And then he says something which is very important. وَكْفِنِي مَا يَشْغَلُنِي الْإِهْتِمَامُ بِهِ. Spare me, O Allah, spare me the concerns which distract me. Sometimes in our way towards Allah, towards Kamal, towards making ourselves better, distractions come. There are things which will disrupt our lives. So you want to focus, otherwise you will forget what you are doing. Here, when you find yourself in that particular situation, you need to pause. You need to stop. If you are standing, sit down. If you didn't have wudu, go perform wudu. Why? Because you want Allah to keep you busy with that which is, what you call it, important, not to be distracted. There is a philosophy, they call it philosophy of silence. I want to ask you a question, brothers. Yeah, we remember first time we went here, we say we will engage one another. Yeah? I ask you a question now. Brothers, when you are entering here tonight, how many colors did you see in this Husseiniyah? Don't look at them. Did you see colors? How many colors did you see when you are entering here tonight? Huh? We don't have the answer. But we come every night here. We see this color, that color, and other colors. Now, inshallah, from now, when you come, you will be aware. You will be aware now. Say, oh, now I need to know the colors. Okay, I'm asking you another question. How many sounds do you hear them now? Mine is one. This one is very clear. Two, yeah? Tell me if you hear any other sound, please. What about this one? Yeah, maybe three. However, if you pay attention, you can hear more than three. Maybe five, maybe six. This is the philosophy, they call it philosophy of silence. When we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we say, Ya Allah, I ask you to make me pay attention to that which is for me. Don't cause any disruption. We live in the world which is full of disruption, and we are distracted with many things. Why? Because of the commotions we live with. Question. Why do we recite Suratul Fatiha and another surah for Salatul Fajr loudly? Why Salatul Dhuhr Asr? Dhuhr and Asr we recite Suratul Fatiha and another surah silently. Maghrib again, loudly. Some scholars say it's because why? We, at that time of Dhuhr, we are distracted but with many things. There's a sound of this and that, and I'm busy, I want to focus, I don't get that. So when you find yourself at peace, silence, you can be able to connect with yourself. That makes you to focus. Shaitan comes to make us busy, not to focus. When you are aware of your surrounding, you see what is near you, it will make you to focus and connect with yourself. You will find peace. When you will be able to hear the sounds which other people don't hear. And this is just a normal exercise people do. But if you make yourself to reach highest level, then you will be able even to see other things which other people do not. And that's why the scholars of Akhlaq say we need time with our moments, with ourselves, in order for us to be able to focus, in order for us to be able to focus with the surroundings and to connect with ourselves. وَاسْتَعْمِلْنِي بِمَا تَسْأَلُنِي غَدًا عَنْهُ. Ya Allah, employ me in that about which you will ask me tomorrow. وَاسْتَفْرِغْ أَيَّامِي فِي مَا خَلَقْتَنِي لَهُ. And let me pass my days in that for which you has created me. You have created me for ibadah. You will ask me tomorrow about that. Why then I find myself busy with other things which are not going to bother you to ask me about? So the dua, Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam, he says, we need to focus on that which keeps us busy for tomorrow when we are going to be asked. وَعَبِّدْنِي لَكَ وَلَا تُفْسِدْ عِبَادَتِي بِالْعُجْبِ. Ya Allah, make me worship you and corrupt not my worship with self-admiration. Al-ujub. In the process of personal development, ujub is like a vinegar when you mix it with milk. Vinegar, when you mix it with honey, it will destroy everything. Ujub. Ujub, self-admiration. They say one particular individual was worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was praying and he was seen to be very humble. And people came to him and they said, MashaAllah, we like the way you pray. He says, no, not only that I'm praying. Today I'm also observing fasting. I'm fasting also. So not only salah, but fasting. Sometimes ujub comes. And especially when we are in with what we tend to think they are normal people. And that's a very wrong thing. We think everyone is a normal people, so we treat them like the way we treat ourselves. Ujub comes. I recite Quran better than everyone. I pray better than anyone. I do wudu better than anyone else. I do ibadah better than anyone else. In self development, if you bring ujub, you are done. It will not make you to reach anywhere else. So Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam says, Ya Allah, I ask you to keep me away from ujub. Imam Zainul Abidin, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. One day when he was praying, one of his servants came and he said, MashaAllah, Ya Imam, your salah reminds me about the salah of Amirul Mu'mineen. We hear salat of Amirul Mu'mineen. Your salah is like salat of Amirul Mu'mineen. Imam Zainul Abidin said, Why hak? Woe be to you. Where is salah of Amirul Mu'mineen compared to my salah? That salah, that prayer of Amirul Mu'mineen is something different. Amirul Mu'mineen, when the arrow was lodged on his feet, they couldn't take it until when he was in salah. Where have you seen that? So ujub is something which will corrupt whatever we do. In the process of self-development, we need to make sure we keep ujub. Always say, I am the ignorant person. I know nothing. I have to start afresh. There were two Maraji friends in Qum. One used to go to his friend almost twice a year. He says, Mawlana, I ask you sincerely for you to check for my wudu. Do I perform wudu better or not? He says, You a marja? Oh, mujtahid at least, you a mujtahid? He says, yes, I want to make sure. If I die, angel should not ask me about my wudu. He says, okay, perform it. He insisted. He performed wudu, the wudu is correct. And then he says, I want you to look at my salah. Check it, if my salah is good. He checks it, he says, it's good. And then he says, I want to present to you my aqidah. I believe in Allah. I believe in what we call usuluddin. Is this correct? He says, correct. He says, Alhamdulillah, if I die, then I die on the sirat al-mustaqim. Where can we find, even within ourselves sometimes? If we want to develop ourselves, personal development, you need to have those kind of friends. Please check my wudu. Please check my salah. Maybe I make mistake. I don't know. This one will raise us, inshallah ta'ala. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us be humble, inshallah. Because shaitan and our nafs will corrupt us most of the time. In Karbala, we see two friends. Friendship is very important for those who are good friends. Very important. Yeah, you know the story of Habib bin Madahir al-Asadi and Muslim bin Awsaja. Muslim bin Awsaja, for some historians, they say he was a Sahabi, a companion of Rasulullah. So he saw Rasulullah, Amirul Mu'mineen, Hassan alayhi salam, until he was at the time of Imam Abi Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam. Hafidhul Quran. He has memorized Quran. He knows Masail Fiqhiyah, each and everything. When Aba Abdullah raised against the government of the time, Muslim bin Awsaja was with Aba Abdullah al-Husayn. Now you know what happened. The eve of Ashura comes. Aba Abdullah al-Husayn calls all his companions and he said, I want to talk to you. He says, Inni wallah, I swear by God, I have never seen companions like you. Companions of Nabiullah Musa, I'm adding this. Companion of Nabiullah Musa, when he said to them, let's go to fight, let's go challenge Fir'aun, what did they say? Idhab anta wa rabbuka faqatila, or idhab anta wa rabbuka faqatila inna ahuna ta'idun. Musa, you and Harun go fight. We will stay here. If you win, we will join you. Companions of Nabiullah Isa, some of them wanted to sell him. Until Allah says, وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُ. They did not kill him. They did not crucify him. But Allah made someone to look like him. Companion of Rasulullah, Raziyatul Khamis, we know what happened. Abba Abdullah is telling them, I have never seen companions like you. But let me tell you one thing. These enemies, they don't want anyone except me. I give you permission. Go take this night as horses. Go, I will not blame you because they don't want you, they want me. People started talking. Muslim bin Awsaja was one of them. He said, Ya Abba Abdullah, what are you telling us? Yani, tomorrow we are going to meet with your grandfather Rasulullah. And then, what are we going to tell him? We left you in Karbala? Maybe Rasulullah will accept it. But what about Amirul Mu'mineen? Will he be able to say, what happened to you? You left my son. Maybe he will understand. But what about Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam? Will the mother allow us to say, oh Zahra, oh Fatima, we left your son in Karbala because he wanted us to leave and we left him alone there. Muslim bin Awsaja said, no. If I am going to be killed and then my body will be chopped into pieces and then burnt and then I'm going to be resurrected again and then being killed and then chopped into pieces and then burnt 70 times, that exercise is repeated, we will never leave you, O Abba Abdullah. This is Muslim bin Awsaja, old man. He went to fight. When he was falling to die, he looked at Habib bin Madahir and said to him, oh Habib, oh my friend, we have been together for quite a long time, but I have a request I'm asking you. You see that man? He points to Abi Abdullah. He says, him, I ask you not to leave him alone. Make sure you are there with him. And he fights also until he attains Shahada. These the ashab of Abu Abdullah and Hussein alayhi salam. Dear brothers and sisters, I want you just to focus on one thing. We recite these masa'ib, we remind one another, but remember the line which says, Tibtum wa tawabatil ardu allati fiha dufintum wa fuztum wallahi fawzan azima faya laytana kunna ma'akum fanafuza ma'akum. These ashab of Hussein were noble people, pure people. They were there for Abu Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam, and that's why whenever you go to recite ziyarah of Abu Abdullah, you will never be able to forget them because they stood with Abu Abdullah. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, we ask you to allow us to go for the ziyarah of Abu Abdullah and his ashab. Ya Allah, we ask you to make us attain the shafa'ah of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein. Ya Allah, we ask you to make us to mend our hearts in order for us not to have ujub, not to have takabbur, not to have anything which will distract and disrupt us and distract us from the way to make our akhlaq to be better, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Rabbana, afrig alayna sabra. وثبت قدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين رحم الله من قرأ الفاتحه مع الصلوات
الله عليك يا رسول الله، السلام عليك يا أمير المؤمنين، السلام عليك يا فاطمة الزهراء سيدة النساء العالمين، السلام عليك يا حسن المجتبى، السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين وعلى أخيك أبو الفضل العباس وأختك زينب وأم كلثوم وبنتك سكينة جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليك على أئمة المسلمين علي بن حسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والحجة بن الحسن. أجعل الله تعالى فرجك وسهل الله مخرجك وظهورك. السلام عليك، السلام عليك يا فاطمة المعصومة جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته.